marcher sans autre but.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mary T. Happy New Year to all my friends, to all my viewers, to all my subscribers. I wish you all a very wonderful new year, a year of success and blessing. Please, if you are new to my channel, subscribe. Click on the notification bell so that you'll be notified anytime I upload a new video. On this video, we'll be making a shirt jumpsuit. A shirt jumpsuit is a short jumpsuit, not long one. A shirt short jumpsuit. So I'll be using this polka dot material. Here we call it polka dot material. So I'll proceed. I've already folded my material. I folded my material into two. And now I want to cut the short part of it. It's a jumpsuit. So I'll cut the damp part of it. So the length of this jumpsuit is 38. And my half length is 16. So 38 minus 16. I'll have 22 left. On that 22, I'll add 1 inch hemming allowance and 1 inch sewing allowance, which will give me 24. So from my waist, here will serve as my waist, where I will join the half length. So my waist, from my waist to my hip is 9 inches. Then from my waist to my crotch, you can call it crotch, you can call it tight, depends on the one. You can call it laps, some call it laps. So from my waist to my crotch is 14 inches. Or better still, I'll do it 13 inches. So I will give the shirt a curve, as in this is my 13 inches and my 9 inches for hip. So from my waist, I hope you're seeing what I'm doing. I place this book here so that this thing will not move out. This table is kind of slippery, so I'll mark 1.5 inch to my waist. Then I'll connect it to the hip. I'll slant it to the hip. I'll mark 1.5 inch to the down part, to the hemming part. Then I'll slant it to the hip. I will put my waist circumferences, my hip circumferences, and my crotch. Then I'll divide my waist by 4. I'll divide my hip by 4. But my crotch or thigh, I'll divide it by 2, not by 4. So my waist measurement is 34 divided by 4 will give me 8.5 plus 2 inches sewing allowance, which will give me 10.5. My hip measurement is 40, divided by 4 will give me 10, plus 2 inches sewing allowance will give me 12. Then my crotch measurement is 26, divided by 2 will give me 13, plus 2 inches sewing allowance, I'll have 15. So I'll connect. This now is for the shorts. Then my ankle measurement is 20. Divide by 2 will give me 10 plus 2 inches, which is 12. My damp part, I mean, not ankle. Sorry about that. My damp part is 20. Divide by 2 will give me 10 plus 2 inches sewing allowance, which is 12. So this is what I have for the shorts. I will explain it again. My length, I got my length. My length is 24 after the whole calculation. My length is 22. After I lost the half length, then I added 2 inches, 1 inch for hemming and 1 inch for sewing allowance, which gave me 24. Then I measured my hip. From my waist to my hip is 9 inches. From my waist to my crotch line is 13 inches. Then this is the damp part. I come in here by 1.5 inches. I slant it to the hip. I come to the damp part by 1.5 inches. I also slant it to the hip. So I put my waist circumferences, my hip circumferences, which I divide them by 4. Then my crotch line, I divide it by 2, giving me what I have here. Then the damp part, I also divide it by 2 because we are cutting a short pant. It's a jumpsuit, sheet jumpsuit. So this is what I have. I'll cut this place out. Then we move to the back. So this is for the front. We move to the back part of it. So now to get the back, I'll mark 1.5 inch here, or rather I'll mark 2 inches here. Then to the damp part, I'll mark 1 inch. I'll connect this 1.5, 2 inches to this 1 inch. Then to this place, I'll mark 1/2 inch. I'll connect this 1/2 inch. Sorry about that. I'll connect this 1/2 inch to the crotch line. This is for the back. Then the waist here, I'll minus 1 inch here. I'll slant it down. Then the back part, I'll add that 1 inch I minus plus extra 1 inch, making it 2 inches. The reason for this is for the back to lap very well. So this is what I have for the back. I hope you are seeing it. This is what I have for the back. So I'll cut it out. I mark 2 inches here. Then the damp part, I mark 1 inches. I connect it together. I mark 1/2 inch here and I curve it to the crotch. Then here in at the front, I lost 1 inch. Then I add that 1 inch plus extra 1 inch to the back, giving me 2 inches. I add it here and I slant it to this point. So to this side, I'll cut it equal. I won't be adding anything on it because this trouser will not have that. This shirt, I mean to say, will not have that. So I'll cut out the 1 inch from the front. So this is it for the, okay, I've not cut out the side, sorry. So this is it for the shirt, this is for the front, and this is for the back. So we'll move to the half length. Sorry, my half length is 17 inches plus 1 inch sewing allowance, which is 18. I made a mistake earlier by saying 16. My half length is 17 inches. Sorry about that. So this is for the half length. From my shoulder to bust measurement is 9 inches. And remember, this is a shirt, so I'll mark out 2.5 inches. It will serve as the bottom blanket. 2.5 inches. I'll mark it all down. So this is the 2.5 inches. And here is my bust line, 9 inches. So my shoulder measurement is 15. 15 divided by 2 will give me 7.5. My bust circumference is, my bust measurement is 38. Sorry, yeah, 36. 36 divided by 2 will give me 18. 18 divided by 2 will give me 9.5, which is 36 divided by 4 will give me 9.5. This is 9.5 plus 2 inches sewing allowance, which will give me 11.5. My waist circumference is 34 divided by 4 will give me 8.5 plus 2 inches sewing allowance, which will give me 10.5. So to my armhole, I'll come to the midpoint. My armhole, my bust is 9 divided by 2 will give me 4.5. I'll come up here by 2. Then I'll curve my armhole like this. This is for the armhole. So the neck, the wideness of the neck, I'll use 2.5. 2.5, and the width I'll use 2.5. So this is for the front. I hope you understand what I do. Let me explain it again. My half length is 17 plus 1 inch sewing allowance, which is 18. I mark out, this is my starting line, I mark it from here to here, which give me 18 inches. Then from my waist to my bust measurement is 9 inches. I mark out my 9 inches. Then I mark out 2.5 inches here. This will serve as the bottom blanket. Then I My shoulder is 15 divided by 2, which gives me 7.5. I bring it down. My bust measurement is 36 divided by 4, which gives me 9.5, plus 2 inches in allowance, which gives me 11.5. My waist is 34 divided by 4, give me 8.5, plus 2 inches, which is 10.5. I mark it out. My neck width is 2.5. The depth is 2.5 also. So I'll cut it out. The shoulder slope. My shoulder slope, I will use 1 inch. This is my shoulder slope. Then, you know, this is shirt. So the back used to be longer than the front. So I will minus another 1 inch here from the front, making it 2 inches. But because I'm cutting directly to my fabric, I will minus 1/2 inches. Instead, I will minus 1.5. Together with the shoulder slope, I will minus 1.5 instead of 2 inches. So I will leave the 1/2 inches. That will serve for the joining the front and the back. So here, I will no longer be minusing 2 inches from the front. I will minus 1.5 inch. So I'll slant it to the neck. Then to the back, I'll add the 1 inch that I minus from the front, plus the 1 inch I'll add to the back, which is 2 inches. I hope you understand what I'm saying. So to cut the neck, I'll fold in this bottom blanket. I'll fold it in. As you can see, I've already folded it, and then I'll cut the neck. Then I'll cut the shoulder slope. So this is what I have for the front. I'll cut the side open. So for this one, to fold the shoulder, to fold the blanket, I have to fold it by 1/2 inch. I'll fold by 1/2 inch, like this. Then I'll fold again by 1 inch. I hope you see that. I will first of all fold by 1/2 inch, like this. After folding by 1/2 inch, then I'll fold again by 1 inch. So this is for the bottom blanket, where the bottom will be. I'll do the same to the other side. So for the front side, I'm done. I will move to the back. So from my waist to my shoulder measurement is 9 inches. This is the 18, I mark out the 18 and I mark out 9 inches for my bust measurement. My shoulder measurement is 15 divided by 2, which will give me 7.5. My bust is 36 divided by 2, which will give me 9.5. Let me reduce this. I have excess. Nine and a half plus 2 inches sewing allowance, which will give me 11.5. Then my waist is 34 divided by 4, give me 8.5 plus 2 inches sewing allowance, which will give me 10.5. To my armhole, I'll come to the midpoint, which is 4.5. And I'll come up here by 2. I'll connect my armhole. So my neck width, I'll use 1 inch. My neck depth, sorry, I'll use 1 inch. My neck width, I'll use 2.5. Then remember, I said I'll be adding, I'll be adding 2 inches from the back, plus 1/2 inch sewing allowance, which is 2.5. So I'll cut this out, then I'll fold this to cut out the neck. So to cut the neck, the back neck, you have to fold it like this and cut. So this is for the back neck. So all I have to do now, this is the back and this is the front. Remember I told you I'll fold here by 1/2 inch, then fold again by 1. I'll do the same to this. So when you are joining the sleeve, the shoulder will no longer be here, the shoulder will be here. It will turn out to be like this. This is will be for the shoulder because it's cape, it's a shaped blouse. So I will join this one, then after joining it, I will cut the cape. I'll show you how I cut the cape. I'll move to sew it and wash it out. I'll join this place together. I'll join it like this. I'll join it together. I'll stitch it. Then the pocket, it has side pockets. I use 7 for the pocket. 7 by 1.5. So I will slant it open like this.
Sans autre but.